Who the heck was that chick up on stage singing with Bradley Cooper?
Bradley Cooper was in that movie? I was gonna say, who the heck was on the stage singing next to Lady Gaga?
Everybody, welcome back to Movies on the Move.
It's
been a little bit of a hot second, and we just saw A Star Is Born.
Star Is Born, definitely comes in with a lot of hype. You've seen the trailers probably 50 billion times if you've been to the movies anytime recently. It's getting some buzz. Is the buzz deserved?
Hi!
Buzz, buzz, buzz.
Well, first of all, the casting was great. I thought Bradley Cooper and Lady Gaga made excellent co-stars. They had really good chemistry together. Bradley Cooper looked really good. And so did Lady Gaga. Very different.
Did they look good together?
Yes.
It's hard to believe that this is Lady Gaga's first actual role in a feature film. I mean, I know musicians sometimes transfer over to movies, but it's not always like you just hop into a really good movie.
No.
And kind of nail your performance. I would say this was a little bit better than
From
Glitter.
Justin to Kelly.
I would say this is a little bit better than classic. Glitter, even though I never saw Glitter.
Another testament I have to point out is that the music was very good.
Yeah, if we're talking about recent movies that are going off their own music, I mean, you had La La Land a few years ago, and I liked a couple of the songs from that. But I do think that the music in this was really good. Like, it sounded like hits that could actually be in real life. And maybe that has to do with that Lady Gaga was delivering it, and she is a musician, and she made it sound great because she has a great voice. But either way, like, a lot of the meaning of this movie came through the lyrics of the songs that they were singing. Maybe it's time to let the old ways down. So the songs were good, they sounded good, but in the same respect, the lyrics that they were delivering were kind of about what they were going through in their lives.
Ain't it hard keeping it so hardcore?
Is that me?
That's you.
In a way, which makes it even more impressive that they were able to make it sound good and make sense in the movie.
What?
It looked like you want to say something.
Also, I don't know if it was just me, but it kind of seemed like each song paid homage to some music legend. Some of it reminded me of Fleetwood Mac. Some of it reminded me of Joe Cocker. Some of it reminded me of Tom Petty.
From the second the movie started, you kind of realize what the characters were all about. You kind of realize their strengths and their flaws.
Mm-hmm. And it's just straightforward.
Yeah, and they both had, you know, a number of strengths and flaws. And you could, at one point, you know, love the character and what they're doing, and then at another point, hate what they're doing, but still love each character, even though they're doing something you don't agree with. And sometimes movies kind of make it so a character is like, oh, you love them at the beginning, and then at the end you're just like, oh, I hate them. But in this case, it's more you don't like what they're doing, but you still know as a person that the character is a good person. And I think that is also a strength. Both characters are likable, but they're likable in a realistic way. They're not perfect. Mm-hmm. And they both know they're not perfect, and they know the other is imperfect, but they understand that and accept that, you know, in a way that's very endearing.
Another thing I liked is that this is not a movie that overdoes it with B plots. There's also Bradley Cooper's character Jackson. He has a subplot with his brother, but it doesn't overtake the film in any way. And I like that it just stuck to its plot. It stuck that, you know, this is also a love story, but it's also about,
it's more about
believing in yourself.
Yeah, believing in yourself.
but then authenticity to go with it.
Yeah, believing in yourself, staying true to yourself. I mean, obviously, for people who want to be movie stars or musicians, it's not going to be, like, for Lady Gaga's character in this movie, it's not going to be so straightforward like you're singing in a drag bar 1 second and you're on stage singing in front of people the next second. But that's what made it so interesting, that this character, Bradley Cooper's character, saw something so special in Lady Gaga that, you know, he was able to give up pretty much, not exactly, but in a way, give up, like, his fame. And yeah. Was kind of, like, guiding the torch to hers.
Oh, he was bae for most of the movie.
So
I want to know if that was him singing.
Yeah, he was, because I heard Lady Gaga in an interview say, like, oh, he has a good voice, and, like, actually, I heard in an interview that the reason she was cast, she was singing jazz in, like, a club, and Bradley Cooper happened to be there, and she was singing La Vie en Rose.
Can I just say something? I think Lady Gaga is a legend.
She's a legend.
I know that's a strong statement, but it's a strong, truthful statement. That voice.
I'll admit that I was probably one of the people a few years ago when she came out in the meat outfit, or whatever it was.
Like, this chick is batshit cray.
Like, I just thought it was an act, but if you just listen to her, and now we're talking about her singing voice, but her acting was great too, but, like, her voice, it's a powerhouse. She's got some instrument, and
I know.
She got acting chops too. Bradley Cooper directed this movie. He co-produced it. He wrote some of the songs in it.
He wrote some of the songs in it?
Yeah, he wrote some of the songs in it.
Wow.
And he obviously acted as one of the leading roles in it. So let's just, you know, it's not easy to do all that and actually make it good. I was just going to say, I think Bradley Cooper really is solidifying himself as, like, top of the actors.
Yeah, to think, guild. You know,
like, he's been nominated a few times, never won. I don't know if he's gonna win for this, but
probably
I'm sure
not.
He'll be nominated. The movie that's so deep had supporting roles played by comedians like Andrew Dice Clay and Dave Chappelle.
How do I want to say this? I kept waiting for that fresh element, you know what I mean? There's something fresh to scowl at me. I kept waiting for this story to tell something new in a way I hadn't seen before, but it didn't exactly happen. Some of the plot was pretty predictable, so that would be my criticism, but I still enjoyed it pretty much as I thought I would.
How do I want to say this? There wasn't anything groundbreaking about it, but I don't think every great movie has to be groundbreaking.
Yeah.
It doesn't have to be.
Sometimes it's what we need.
Groundbreaking. It just has to tell a good story and get you feeling the places where you're supposed to feel. So that wouldn't be a criticism for me, per se.
True.
I guess if there was any sort of criticism, it did kind of, I don't know if I want to say disappoint me, or what's the word is, but what I will say is, normally, around this time of year, I get a little bit nervous because it's creeping towards Oscar season, like a little, like, 2 months before Christmassy, and usually the Oscar movies come out around Christmas, and normally, I'm not feeling anything yet, but I will say, in the last weeks or month, me and Rebecca have seen Eighth Grade and Black Klansman. Both, I think, could be Oscar contenders,
mm-hmm.
and both, you know, we both really enjoyed, mm-hmm. and I also saw Searching with Harold from Harold and Kumar, John Cho, which I also thought was amazing. I don't know or think if it will get any Oscar cred, but I do think it deserves it. And then this, which obviously is getting all the Oscar buzz, and I think, you know, it deserves it as much as any other movie that's probably going to get Oscar buzz. It definitely, you know, is a contender. Like, if we're comparing it to
original song.
Yeah, like, I'm not, no, I think it will get nominated for Best Picture for sure.
I enjoyed A Star Is Born. I will give it 4.5 stars out of 5. It was almost 4, but that final shot.
Final shot did it?
That I was almost at that final shot. It was so simple, but that final shot.
You and these final shots.
That final shot was a button. That was good. What a smashing button.
I'll give it 4.5 stars. It wasn't perfect, but it was close to perfect. And giving it 4 stars is like...
too low. Not fair.
Because there are movies that we give 4 stars to that aren't as good as it.
Yeah.
You know, I would love to see Lady Gaga at least be nominated for Best Actress. I think that'd be awesome.
Yeah, I don't think we even have credit to her performance. And I don't mean just musically. I mean her acting as well. Yeah,
his performance was good too, but it was like, you know, generic drunk.
Yeah, but he did, you know, it's hard to play drunk.
I'm tired. I'm wasted. I love you, darling.
He did well. He did extremely well.
And he could be nominated for Best Director and Best Actor. Who the hell knows?
Yeah.
Because I thought it was directed very well, too. I thought the way they shot it, there were a lot of interesting shots that I think made it interesting.
It didn't do anything ultra cinematic, though. It was pretty...
But there were those scenes where, like, she was recording and you saw, like, her reflection in the things, which I thought was better than just, you know, showing her... In those scenes. So I definitely think that, you know, he did a good job directing it because it flowed really, really well. Towards the middle of the movie, he was like calling her on stage, like, oh, I'm going to bring Allie out to sing an original song. Did you think she was going to sing Bad Romance?
No.
Oh, I guess that was just me then.
Why would I think that?
I don't know. Because she's Lady Gaga. I thought she was going to sing Bad Romance.
No, the reason why...
now we're still talking.
The reason why I didn't recognize her is because I noticed later on in the movie, Lady Gaga is very known for her fake lashes, and she had them on, and I was like, okay, no, that's Lady Gaga.
What do you mean you didn't recognize her? You knew it was Lady Gaga.
When I saw the trailer for this movie, I said, who's that chick in the movie with Bradley Cooper? And then I saw Lady Gaga, I'm like, what?
What did you think of A Star Is Born? Were you surprised by Lady Gaga's performance? Do you think that Bradley Cooper directed the film well? Let us know what you thought. Do you think it deserves all the buzz it's getting?
Ow! And be sure to like, comment, subscribe for more content. And we will see you next time.